Welcome to class 6 chapter 1 knowing our numbers. Earlier we have studied about number system. In that we have studied that there are two number system. First is Indian number system and second is international number system. Today we are going to learn more about international number system. Place value chart for international number system. Here you can see a 9 digit number. Let's count. Is it 9 digit number or not? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. It's a 9 digit number. Now 5 is on the 1's place, 1 is on the 10's place, 9 is on the 100 place, 7 is on the 1000 place, 8 is on the 10,000 place, 2 is on the 100,000 place, and 3 is on the million place, 4 is on the 10 million place, and 6 is on 100 million. Here you can see 1s, 10s, 100, 1000, 10,000, 100,000. After that comes million. Million, 10 million, 100 million. Now in Indian number system, what you have studied till here? 1s, 10s, 100, 1000, 10,000, it remains the same for Indian and for international number system. But from 100, here for 100,000, what we used to write? We used to write lakhs. For million, what we used to write? We used to write 10 lakhs. For 10 million, it was 1 crore. And for 100 million, it was 10 crore. So, main difference between Indian number system and international number system is that here 100,000 is equal to lakhs in Indian number system. Million is equal to 10 lakhs. Don't get confused that lakh is equal to million. Lakhs is equal to 100,000 and million is equal to 10 lakhs. And 10 million is equal to crore and 100 million is equal to 10 crore. Now we will move to the next topic. Now we will learn how to put commas between the numbers. Here ones, tens, 100, 1000, 10,000, 100,000, million, 10 million, 100 million. Now here how we will put the commas. First we will see how these boxes are divided. First, ones, tens, hundreds are always in one block. Now another, these three, you can see all of these three are of 1000. So this is another block. And these three are of million. So this will be the third block. Now what we will do? We will put commas. After leaving three digits, we will put comma. Again leaving three digits, we will put comma. We have to start always putting commas from the right hand side. So between 7 and 9, there will be a comma. Between 3 and 2, there will be a comma. So how you will read this number? We will start from this side. This is 3 numbers. Suppose it is 43 numbers, then how you will read? You will read it as 643. Same you have to read in international number system. 643,287,950. We will write down the number name. So in international number system, the number name is as given, 643,287,950. 87,950. But in Indian decimal system, if we want to write the number, what will we do? How we will put the commas? We will first this 3. After that, leaving 2, we will put comma. After leaving 2, we will put comma. So it will be written 64,32,87,950. But in international number system, the system of commas is little different. We have to put after giving 3 digits, after giving again 3 and again 3. So 3 that is there. How to write place value of the given number? Now first, place value of 6 is 100 million, which will be equal to 6. After that, how many zeros we have to put? After 6, all digits we have to put 0. So there will be 8 zeros. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, which will be 600 million. Place value of 4 is 10 million. So after 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 zeros. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Now place value of 3 is million. After 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 zeros. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So it will be 3 millions. Now place value of 2 is 100,000. After 2, how many zeros? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 zeros. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, which will be 200,000. Place value of 8 is 10,000. So after 8, there will be 4 zeros. 1, 2, 3, 4, which will be 8,000. Now place value of 7 is 1000, 7000. Place value of 9 is 100, means 900. Place value of 1 is 10, it will be equal to 10. Place value of 5 is 1. Now whenever you are told that write the place value of 8, another you are not told to write, only you have to write the place value of 8 in the given number. So directly what you will do, after 8 you will put 1, 2, 3, 4, whatever how many digits are there, after 8 that way you will make them 0. This is the simple trick to write down the place value of any number. Exercise 1.1, question number 1, fill in the blanks. You are given fill in the blanks in this question. First A, 1 lakh is equal to how many? 10,000. For this, what you have to do? You should know how many zeros are there in 1 lakh. In 1 lakh there are 5 zeros. This I have written only for understanding. It is not given in the textbook. It will be equal to how many? 10,000. 10,000 has how many zeros? 10,000 will be 1 after that 1, 2, 3, 4 zeros. Now here there are 4 zeros. Here we want 5 zeros. What we will multiply with this number, then we will get 5 zeros, we will multiply it by 10. So our required answer is 10,000 is equal to 1 lakh. Next, 1 million is equal to how many? 100,000. So 1 million, how many zeros are there in million? There are 6 zeros. Here 100,000 means it will be 1 after that 100, 2 zeros, 1000, 3 zeros. Total there are 5 zeros. We need 6 zeros. What will we multiply? We will multiply it by 10. So this is our required answer. 10,000 is equal to 1 million, or 1 million is equal to 10,000. Now 1 crore is equal to how many? 10 lakhs. 1 crore has how many zeros? 1 crore has 7 zeros. Here 10 lakh means lakh, you know, it has 5 zeros and again 10 has 1 zero. So it has 6 zeros. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is 10 lakhs. So we need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 zeros are left. We need 7 zeros. So we will multiply it by 10. So 10 is the required answer. So here we will put 10. So 1 crore is equal to 10 lakhs. Again 1 crore is equal to how many? Millions. 1 million is 1 crore. we want how many zeros? 7 zeros we need. So we will put 10 multiplied by 10. This is the required answer. So it will be 10 million. 1 crore is equal to 10 million. Now 1 million is equal to how many lakhs? Now 1 million has how many zeros? It has 6 zeros. Lakh has only 5 zeros. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is 1 lakh. We need one more zero multiplied by 10. So 1 million is equal to 10 lakhs. From exercise 1.1, question 2, question 3 and question 4 you have to do by yourself. Now we will move to the next topic. Topic 1.3, large numbers in practice. Now large numbers, we have learned about the large numbers. Which are large numbers? Lakhs, crore, million, all these are large numbers. Now these large numbers we have to use in our daily life. So in earlier classes we have learned that we use centimeter in cm as a unit of length for measuring the length of pencil, width of book or notebook etc. We use centimeters. For centimeters is used for the measuring the length of pencil. For measuring the pencil we need only centimeters. Width of book, it is also small, so we will use centimeters. Our ruler has marks on each centimeter. Here you can see a ruler, it has marks. This is 13 centimeter, 12 centimeter, 11 centimeter. From 0 it will start with 15 centimeter. Now for measuring the thickness of pencil, however, we find centimeter too big. Now when we have to know the thickness of any book or chalk or pencil, if suppose the thickness of chalk we want to find out, then for this centimeter will be a large unit. So we will use a smaller unit which is called millimeter. We use millimeter to show the thickness of pencil. Now what are the relation between centimeters and millimeters? So first 10 millimeters is equal to 1 centimeter. 1 centimeter will be equal to 10 millimeters. To measure the length of classroom or the school building, we shall find the centimeter too small. Now when the scale becomes larger, the things becomes larger, the unit also becomes more larger. So for measuring the length of classroom, if you want to measure the classroom, your classroom is big. So if you will start measuring with the ruler, then it will take time. So for that we have to use meter. We use meter for that purpose. Now relation of meter and centimeter, millimeter, we will see. 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeters and 1 centimeter is equal to 10 millimeters. So 1 meter will be equal to 1000 millimeters. This you have to learn. Even meter is too small when we have to state distance between cities, say Delhi and Mumbai or Chennai and Kolkata. For this we need kilometers. Now whenever you are walking or traveling, you use kilometers for that. For distance between any two cities we use kilometers, which is a little larger unit than meter. 1 kilometer is equal to 1000 meters. How many millimeters make 1 kilometer? Since 1 meter is equal to 1000 millimeter, so 1 kilometer is equal to 1000 meter. This you have learned in the lower classes. Now we will convert it into millimeter. So 1000 meter is equal to 1000 multiplied by 1000 millimeter. It will be equal to 10 lakhs millimeter. So 1 kilometer is equal to 10 lakhs millimeter. So this was all about the length. The greater unit is kilometer and the smallest unit is millimeter. We go to the market to buy rice or wheat. We buy it in kilograms, but items like ginger or chilies, which do not need in large quantities, we buy in grams. Now it is all about the weight. If we want rice and wheat, then we will buy them in kilograms. We need their quantity in kilograms, means more quantity we need. And for ginger and chilies, this we need in small quantity, so we will use grams for it. Now what is the relation between kilogram and gram? We know 1 kilogram is equal to 1000 grams. Have you noticed the weight of the medicine tablets given to the sick? It is very small. It is in milligrams. Now more smaller than gram is milligrams. So 1 gram is equal to 1000 milligrams. This is relation between gram and milligrams. So the highest is kilogram. After that it is gram and after that it is milligram. So the smallest unit is milligrams. What is the capacity of a bucket for holding water? Now you have seen a bucket. For holding water we use liters. It is usually 12 liters, means L it may be for 15 liters, 10 liters. Different capacities are available. Capacity is given in liters. Now whenever we want to know about the liquid things, we use capacity. But sometimes we need a smaller unit, the milliliter. Here also, sometimes we need large quantity and sometimes we need smaller quantities. For large quantities, we know we use liters. For smaller quantities, like a bottle of hair oil, a cleaning liquid or a soft drink, have labels which give the quantity of liquid inside in milliliters, means ml. You have seen a bottle of hair oil of 500 ml, 200 ml. Different type of quantities are given on it. So 1 liter is equal to 1000 milliliters. So the greater is liter. After that is what it is? It is liter. After that it is milliliter. Only two quantities are there, liter and milliliters. Note that in all these quantities, all these units, we have some words common like kilo, milli and centi. These are the same words used every time with kilo, milli and centi. We should remember that among these, kilo is the greatest and milli is the smallest. Kilo shows 100 times greater, milli shows 1000 times smaller. That is 1 kilogram is equal to 1000 grams. And 1 gram is equal to 1000 milligrams. Similarly, centi shows 100 times smaller, that is 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeters. Now, these are the relation given between kilograms and grams, that they are kilogram and milligrams are having difference of 1000 and centimeter and meter are having difference of 100. Now, we will move to the next question. Here, before this, we have to learn about the speed. We will learn about the speed. We will learn about speed. Your definition of speed is given. Speed is defined as distance covered by an object per unit time. So whatever distance any object is covering in per unit time, means it will be unit means 1. So the formula for getting speed, it will be equal to speed is equal to distance traveled divided by time taken. So S is equal to d by t. Now speed is measured in kilometer per hour. Now when distance and speed are given, you have to find out the time. So there is another formula. Time is equal to distance divided by speed. And whenever speed and time are given, and you have to find out distance, then the formula is distance is equal to speed multiplied by time. Here question is given in your textbook. Question number 1. A bus started its journey and reached different places with a speed of 60 km per hour. Here speed is given of a bus, which is 60 km per hour. The journey is given on page 14. Here you can see the journey of bus is given in this picture. First, I find the total distance covered by the bus from A to D. Second, find the total distance covered by the bus from D to G. Find the total distance covered by bus if it starts from A and returns back to the A. Can you find the difference of distance from C to D and D to E? In first one, we have to find out the total distance covered by the bus from A to D. Total distance, it is given, means we have to do addition A to D. Now, from A to D, what is the path? You can see from A to D, it is The distance is 4170 kilometers. From B to C it is 3410 kilometers. From C to D it is 2160 kilometers. So all these three we have to add, then we will get the answer. We move to the solution. So the here my answer, distance from A to B plus distance from B to C plus distance from C to D, then we will get our required answer, the distance covered by the bus from A to D, which will be equal to, here distance from A to B it is given 4170 kilometers. Here distance from B to C is given 3410 kilometers. Distance from C to D is given 2160 kilometers. These three digits we have to add. Here we will do rough work. Here 000 is addition of 000 is 0. Now 7 plus 1 plus 6 it will be 14. 4, 5, 6, 1, 7. So 7. 4 plus 3 plus 2 it will be 9. Here this you have to show this calculation in the rough work. And after that you have to write down, it will be equal to 9740 kilometers. Second and third you have to do by yourself. We will move towards the fourth. Can you find the difference of distance from C to D and D to E? Here what you have to find out, the difference. Difference means what you have to do, addition or subtraction. We have to do subtraction. Subtraction between which two? So distance from C to D and from D to E. So first we will know what is the distance from C to D. So the distance from C to D is equal to 2160 kilometers. Now distance from D to E is given 8140 kilometers. From this two, which is the larger number? This is the larger number. So we will minus from this digit. From this number we will minus this number. So the difference will be equal to 8140 kilometers minus 2160 kilometers. If we go for the rough work, 8140 minus 2160. 0 minus 0 is 0. Now 4 minus 6. From 4 you can't minus 6 because 4 is smaller than 6. So we will go for borrow. We will borrow from here one digit. So it will become 14, and here out of 1 we have given it to this side, so it will remain only 0. So 14 minus 6 it will be 8. Here it is only 0. Now we will take a borrow from 8, so it will become 10, and here 1 we have given to 0. So here how many left out of 8? Only 7 are left. So 10 minus 1 is equal to 9. Here 7 minus 2 is equal to 5. So the required answer is 5980 kilometers. Find out the time taken by the bus to reach A to B, B, C to D, C, E to G, and D total journey. First we will find out from the time taken from A to B. Now we know that for finding out time we have a formula that time is equal to distance by speed. So we should know what is speed given over here. So speed you are given in the first sentence only, it was that of a 60 km per hour. So we will find out the solution of the first one and the rest are homework. A to B. So we have to find out time taken from travelling A to B. So time taken is equal to distance from A to B divided by the speed. So distance from A to B is given that 4170 kilometers. It is the distance divided by speed, which is 60 km per hour. Here 00 will cancel out. So we have to divide 417 divided by 6. We will go for the rough work. Here 417 divided by 6. First 41, less than 41, 36 comes in the tables of 6. So 6 is that 36. 41 minus 36 is equal to 5. Here 5 we have written. Now this 5, 7 we will bring it down. So it will become 57. Now 57 we have 5 9 are 54. So sorry, 6 9 are 54. So we will go for the subtraction. 57 minus 54, it will be equal to 3. Now 3 will not come in the table of 6 because it is less than 6. So what we will do? We will put point over here. So now we can put 0 over here. So 3 0 30 comes in the table of 6. So 6 5 are 30. So our remainder is 0. So our answer is 69.5. What we have to find out time? So the unit of time is here, it is hour. If you want to convert this into hour and minute, what we will do? 69 will be hour and 0.5 minutes. 0.5 means half. So 69 hour is equal to half hour. Sorry, it is not minute, it is in the hour. Half hour is equal to 30 minutes. So the answer is 69 hour and 30 minutes. Till here also if the answer is right, and if you want to convert it into hour and minutes, this is also your right answer. Example 1. Population of Surendranagar was 2,35,471 in the year 1991. In the year 2001, it was found to be increased by 72,958. What was the population of the city in 2001? Now in 1991, total population is given that it was 2,35,471. And in 201, it is found it is increased. Only the number, how many is increased, that much number is only given. And what we have to find out is the total population in the city in 2001. So for finding out the population in 2001, what we have to do? Add these two numbers. So the population of city in 2001, it will be equal to population in the city in 1991 plus increase in population. So we will add 2,35,471 plus 72,958. We will go for the rough work and we will get the answer 30,8,429. Now here another two methods are given. They are based on the expansion. But basically we use this method only for the addition. Now example 2. In one state, the number of bicycles sold in year 2002 and 2003 was 7,43,000. In the year 2003-2004, the number of bicycles sold were 8,100. In which year were more bicycles sold and how many more? Here, two values are given about the bicycles sold in 2002-2003 and another in 2003 and 2004. Two different numbers are given over here, this and this. You have to find out in which year more bicycles are sold. For more bicycles, what do you have to go for? Out of these two numbers, which is the greater number? Here first number is 7, here first number is 8 in this number, so obviously this is the larger number. So in 2003 and 2004, the number of bicycles sold are more. So clearly 8,100,000 is more than 7,43,000. So in that state, more bicycles were sold in the year 2003-2004 than in 2002 and 2003. Now we have another question, that how many more? We want that number, that how much more bicycles were sold. For that we have to go for difference or subtraction. From larger number we will subtract the smaller number. So we will get the answer 57,100. Now whether this answer is right or wrong, we will go for the cross check. If we will add whatever number we are minusing, that to the answer we will get the the first number. So we will add these two numbers. Then we will get 8,100, which is equal to this number. So our answer is correct. Next, example 3. The town newspaper is published every day. One copy has 12 pages. Every day, 11,980 copies are printed. How many total pages are printed every day? Now here, what we have to do? One copy, 12 pages. How many copies are published every day? 11,980. One page for one copy, this much page. Then for this much copies, how many? We have to find out for more numbers. So for more numbers, we always go for multiplication. So the solution, each copy has 12 pages. Here 11,980 copies will have how many? It will be 12 multiplied by 11,980 pages. So 11,980 multiplied by 12. We will go for column multiplication. Here first we will start the multiplication from the ones place. 0 to the 0, 8 to the 16, 1 carry and 6 over here. 9 to the, it is 18, plus 1, it will be 19, 1 carry, and now 9 we will write down. So 1 to the 2 plus 1 means 3, 1 to the 2. Here multiplication with 2 is over. Now multiplying with 1, so with 2, here 2 we are not multiplying. So on the 1's place we will put 0 first, after that we will go for multiplication with 1. So 0 on the 0, 8 on the 8, 9 on the 9, 1 on the 1, again 1 on the 1. These two numbers we will go add them, we will get 0 plus 0, it is 0, 6 plus 0, 6, 9 plus 8, it is 17, 9 plus 3, it is 13, 2, 3, 1, 4, plus this 1 over here. So the answer is 1,43,760 pages are printed. Now another example. The number of sheets of page available for making notebooks is 75,000. Here more number are given, you have to find out for the less. So from more we want to find out, for less we will use division. Each sheet makes 8 pages of a notebook. Each notebook contains 200 pages. How many notebooks can be made from the page available? So notebooks are given, pages of the notebooks are also given, and how many pages the notebook should contain, that is also given. So each sheet makes 8 pages. So a sheet is given, out of that how many pages you can get? 8 pages you can get. So total how many pages you have? For getting out the total pages, we have to multiply it by 75,000. Here 75,000 sheets make 8 multiplied by 75,000 pages. That much pages are available. So now we will go for multiplying 75,000 multiplied by 8. 75,000 multiplied by 8, it will be 66 lakhs. Thus, 6 lakhs pages are available for making notebooks. Now, we know that for one notebook, we have 200 pages. Now, total pages, we have 6 lakhs. And we want to make notebooks of 200 pages. So, what we will do? We will divide it. So, hence 6 lakhs pages make 6 lakhs divided by 200 notebooks. 6 lakhs divided by 200, it will be 3,000. Thus, the answer is 3,000 notebooks are there. Exercise 1.2, from question 1 to 7, you have to do by yourself. Now, question 8. A student multiplied 7,236 by 65 instead of multiplying by 56. By how much was his number greater than the correct answer? Now, the student is given that you have to multiply 7236, multiply it by 56, but he is multiplying with 65. So, what is the basic thing first we will do is that 7,236 will be multiplied by 65. 65 and 7236 is multiplied by 56. From both the answer, which will be greater? 7236 multiplied by 65 will be greater. After that, we need that how much greater than answer we want. So we will go for difference. This is greater answer out of this multiplication. This answer we will minus it from 7236 multiplied by 56 answer. This you can do in the traditional method, but some shortcut method is given. So here student multiplied by mistake. What is the mistake? That he has multiplied 7236 multiplied by 65. This is the mistake he has done. Actually what he is given, he have to multiply 7236 with 56. Now directly we are not going to multiply and get the answer. Directly we will go for the difference. Difference in student's answer and correct answer, it will be equal to which will be the larger? This answer will be greater and this will be the smaller. Out of these two numbers, this number is greater and this number is smaller. So answer of this number will be greater. So that we will write down first. After that, minus 7236 multiplied by 56. Now, out from these two brackets, which digit you can find in common? This digit you can find common. So we will write this digit only once. 7236. Now what is another thing? 65 minus 56. Both the answers, the common thing we have written once. Once we have written 7236. Now leftover part will be write down. It will be 65 minus 56. So in one bracket we will write down 65 minus 56. What will be the answer? 65 minus 56. So it will be 9. This we will copy down. 7236 multiplied by 9. So the answer will be 65,126. So without multiplying these two, we are directly finding out the difference.